And welcome back to the Endless Mod Pack. So, just to let people know, and I will tell you why in a second, I have disabled a mod, the Advent of Ascension, because it was causing me some problems. If you've watched Nicole BW's video, you may have seen the portal appearing and damaging some of her buildings. It was basically doing the same to me, but instead of damaging my building, it was destroying my smeltery. And it didn't just do it once, it did it twice, and it even left a nice gaping hole right through to the surface, because this was where the portal actually was. So yeah, it kind of, and it just didn't do it once, it did it twice, because it destroyed the smeltery. Like I said, the smeltery drains, both of them gone, and it just went straight up through it. Just a pain in backside. So once I can put up with, twice new. So that's why I've decided to remove that mod. It's a bit of a shame, because I know it's kind of like a dimensional mod pack, and you know, but never mind, we've still got plenty of other mods to play with. We actually got some glowstone and redstone in there, that's nice. But yeah, everything's still working. I've got plenty of chaos oil now, two full iron drums, and getting a third one well under the way. I have been into the Nether. My portal is just down here. Nothing really different in the Nether. I just really went in to see if I could find some vulcanite, or to try and find some blaze rods, with no success. I could not find any vulcanite. If you don't know what I'm meaning, if I, come on, there we go, this is a vulcanite ore just here. It's found in the Nether. It's supposed to be found, as I understand it, near lava, but I couldn't find any. And what you do with that, you can smelt it down. Go on, get the right recipe down to get the vulcanite ingots. And then through that, you can, if it will show us, come on, don't be a pain. There you go, two of them will make one blaze rod, and then you're good to go. But like I say, I couldn't find any, so that's why I started creating some thermal expansion machines. I've got my pulverizer, which obviously all doubles, and the furnace, which cooks. No big difference there, but the magma crucible and whatnot. What you can actually do to get blaze powder. There we go. Let's have a look, see if it all shows. There we go. Some destabilized redstone with glowstone to make blaze powder. So yeah, that's why you need the magma crucible to get the redstone stuff, and then obviously the fluid transposer to get your blaze powder. But blaze powder is no longer an issue for me, so we're all good there. So I was able to make the blast furnace from Immersive Engineering, which is being fed charcoal from my charcoal chest here, which is slowly running out. It does use quite a bit of charcoal, this thing. But here I have another condenser, just like I have behind here for the wood. But this one is making iron, which is automatically feeding into this. So the charcoal and iron will make me steel. And as you can see, I have been AFKing quite a bit to make some steel, because this stuff is fairly important for future users. Not only can I upgrade some of my tools, it is also used for making drills, conveyor belts, extended magazines, things for the gun, HV wiring. So yeah, I'm gonna need quite a lot of it, and I'm even gonna use some now. At least three pieces, because today I want to concentrate on upgrading my power. Because you can see, I've got an energy cube here and some immersive wire connectors and things like that, which I'll just snip upstairs and show you the, my current power supply. Let's actually sleep first and make it day. Where is my bed? Here it is. So let's just make it day, and then we should be able to see things a little bit easier. And it should also get rid of the rain. So here we are, this is my power supply. Just three basic windmills. They are actually standing on these wooden posts. To make the wooden posts from Immersive Engineering. Let's just see if I can find them. There they are. It's just some stone bricks and treated wood. You should know how to make stone bricks, hopefully. But the treated wooden fence is the treated sticks, which I showed in the last episode. So that's how you would make them, and I thought they looked fairly cool when I saw that people were using them in this sort of fashion, and they look really decent to my mind. So, and I've also connected some MV connectors all the way up there, and these are all MV wires, medium volt wiring. So hopefully this should get an upgrade fairly soon. But even with these three, it's still not quite enough power to power everything that I have downstairs. Not too bad for the furnace, because that only requires 20 RF per tick. The main problem, actually, believe it or not, is the pulverizer, because that takes about 40 RF per tick. So let me just grab some ferocious ore and stick that in there, and you'll see it drains very, very quickly. Because this is obviously doing 40 RF per tick, and then when this is going, that's 20 RF per tick. So, yeah. So I really do need to upgrade them. So what I've been doing off camera is preparing some improved windmill blades. To make these guys, you need the windmill blades, which we made last time, and the tough fabric. The tough fabric is a normal stick and plenty of industrial hemp, which I actually made a large farm for, which I'll show you in a second. Now, I think I've got enough here for about three, I hope. Yeah, I've got enough there for three, so I just need three steel, and then we should be able to upgrade them, and we'll see how we go for that. There's the three improved windmills, so let's get these up and running. This is my hemp farm, by the way. I managed to get it fully operational, and I've also got a sprinkler down there being fed with an Aquilus accumulator, which is feeding into a tank, and then the sprinkler, and it does work on it as well. Don't forget though, when you're harvesting this, do the top one, also do the bottom one as well, because that will give you even more there, and it should give you an extra seed. So you should be able to get plenty of stuff that way. Yes, and that reminds me, I made the practicalities magnet, which is made like such. The north and the south magnetic things, and the radiant core. The radiant core is an enderpearl, and for gold, the magnetic saw at north is two iron and redstone. The south is two iron and lapis, and you just put them together to make the magnet. So yeah, right, let's get these guys improved. So that means I need to become the bat. Okay, let's get up there. So I don't know how exactly these guys will improve my power situation, but it should be a lot better. Let's have a look at these guys. Whoa, oh, that's spinning. Whoa, that's a lot faster. That's cool. That's really, really cool. More I see this mod, the more I like it. Let's get you up and running. I don't know how far away these guys need to be from each other, but at the moment, yeah, I think this works a little bit better. So let's get rid of this guy. I might set these guys back up as well, just because they do provide power. There's no problems there. But yeah, so we've now got three improved windmills, which is absolutely awesome. So we'll take a look at that in a moment. I just want to come back to the posts. You may notice that these are all singled, and this one has three. And by the way, you don't need to set the wiring up like this. This is just what I did to make it look, well, what I think looks a lot better, especially like the droop in the wire. And that is just one wire, by the way. So that one wire is also the same as that one wire, and so on and so forth. So I think I mentioned this in the last episode. One wire can go up to 17 blocks, so shouldn't be too much difficulty getting things sorted. But you may notice that this wooden post is different because it's got these bits here. What you do to get them, and I can do it on this, is that on one of the sides here, all you have to do is right click and it will actually bring one up, and you can do the same on the opposite side, and you can right click on those to get rid of them, and you can put them on this side as well. However, you can't have one here and here. They have to be opposite each other. And then you can put your transformers or whatever on top of them. So I thought that was kind of cool. And like I say, I think I could, like I said, I didn't have to do it this way. I could have quite easily connected this wire to here and then sent it straight down, and that wire to there and sent it straight down. And I could have saved myself a little bit of messing around, but like I say, I think this kind of looks cool. I don't think there's any power loss, which how many you use, so it shouldn't be too much of a issue. So let's morph back into our normal self, and we will head back down here, and we need to just get rid of them. I made these Java barrels just to hold the items in for now, and yeah, that's finished. Let's see if we've actually got anything else to pulverize. We've got some aluminium there. Let's just stick the aluminium in, shall we? Let's see if that holds any better. Yes, that's holding. That's awesome. So they do obviously provide a little bit more power, but I'm happy with that. But we can hopefully add a bit more power, because I've also created three water wheels, which I don't really know exactly how to set up just yet, so I'm going to just have a quick look through the book. And you see power, wires and generators. Let's have a look with that. Power generation. So I need another kinetic dynamo. Don't let me forget that I need one of them. That's the windmills. There we are, the water wheel. The water wheel is fairly easy way of powering a dynamo. Its turning speed is based on the water flowing around it. So for optimal results, you'll want to direct the water in a semicircle from the top down. Okay. One side and along the bottom. From the top down, one side and along the bottom. To three water wheels can be placed against each other. That's why I made three. And that's your crafting recipe. The treated sticks in a four, and then the three make them, and then you need the segment four of them to make one water wheel. So a fairly easy recipe once you've got enough oil. It's just setting it up, which could be a little bit complicated. Hopefully not too bad. So let's make our dynamo first, which is there. Dynamo. What's that? Dynamo Tinker's Network. Okay. Anyway, so we need some copper wiring around some there. So we've got plenty of copper wiring. We're replacing it with medium volt. I need a bit of iron. Make this guy some copper wire, and then I need three more iron and two redstone. Two redstone, three iron. Okay. Here's a question for you. I'm gonna have to look back in the video myself. Did I take six steel, or did that not make the water wheels? The windmills. Strange. I'm sure I only picked up three steel, didn't I? Have I got any other blocks on me? No, I have not. Done. Right, let's grab some. Just some a little bit of dirt for now. Because this is the first time I've tried to set these guys up. So if I make a fool of myself on camera, so be it. I'm pretty much used to that already. So let's just put these guys over here. I don't think it let me turn into bat form so I can fly as well. And it's turning night already. I don't know how high these guys can be or anything like that. So let's just stick this guy here, and then we want the water wheels. One there, one there, and one there. Alright, cool. So we need. I think what we need to do get rid of you for starters, and put that there. You'll see why I'm doing this in a second if it's the way I think it needs to go. This is more of experimenting on camera, which may or may not be a good thing. So I think that needs to go there. That do anything? Yes, no, maybe. Doesn't look to be doing anything, so we'll get rid of you. And we'll do a little bit more dirty tactics. Let's do this for now. Don't really want you to go there though. Bear with me on this. Okay, so that's got the water flowing. Still not moving as such. Do I need to do that? Get rid of you. No, that's just going to make it do that anyway. Okay, maybe I just need to get all three buckets up and running as such. Let's do that. It so it only goes around the mill itself. Alright, cool. And then what we need to do is get in here. Still not moving, but then it could be with it being in water as well, which might be the problem I'm facing. Let's dig this lot out. Right, okay, so take two, let's bring them up so they're floating in the air slightly, and let's try this again in a way. Let's bring that up and across. Last time, and you can go there and block you off. Do something on those sorts of lines as well. Okay, let's try this first bucket again, see what happens. Anything at all? Doesn't look to be doing much, does it? Oops, I now did dirt as well. Okay. Are you there? So I don't know if this really needs to go under as well. We will figure this out. Okay, let's grab a little bit more dirt and we'll see what is what. Okay, so. Oh, this will work. If that really needs to go higher, actually. Think it does, doesn't it? Gone. Okay. And this is why I use dirt. So let's try from there, I think, this time. Does that still need to go higher? Okay, I told you I'd make a fool of myself on camera. Okay, that looks a little bit better. Aha, we've got movement. Slow movement, but we have got movement. Okay, so it does work. Sort of. Aha, that's better, that's better. So it's only going one way now, which is good. But yeah, it's working. I don't know how, but it is working. Yeah, it's a little bit messy, I know that. But this is just some experimenting and trying to get things to work. I do think, though, that the water does need to try and flow more underneath it. Let's try. Do I need this bottom bit? No, I don't. Good. That, I think, and that, and that. For them. Okay, not the most attractive thing in the world. I will try to make it look a little bit better and obviously move it more probably over here somewhere. This was just to see if I could actually get it to work, and it does seem to work. So yeah, like I said, I was just experimenting. I don't know exactly if this is fully optimal way of doing it. If you do know a better way of doing it, feel free to leave a comment. But yeah, I think I'm gonna leave this episode here. So thank you very much for joining me, and I will see you next time. Bye.